were discussing about pronouns. We have already discussed about the personal pronouns and the possessive pronouns. Today we will be talking about the other more important category, that is reflexive pronouns and the emphatic pronouns. You need to pay a little more attention because they are a bit confusing. So the reflexive pronouns are the pronouns which are used to refer back to the subject. They are the pronouns which refer back to the subject when the action done by the subject refers back to the subject itself. Fine? For example, you can see here, I hurt myself. Now this action of hurting is reflecting upon the subject only. The action of hurting is reflected upon the subject, and it is represented by the word myself. It is represented by the word myself. It is very important to understand that the reflexive and the emphatic pronouns can be formed by adding self or selves to the words personal pronouns which we have already read. My, myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself. When we are talking about plural, we use ourselves, yourselves and themselves. So when the pronoun it is referring back upon the subject, we call it a reflexive pronoun. But when the reflexive pronouns, they put emphasis on the subject, they are putting emphasizing on the subject again and again, we call them as emphatic pronouns. When the reflexive pronouns are used to put emphasis on the subject, you can see here in the sentence, I myself got hurt. We are giving emphasis to I myself got hurt. I myself. We are emphasizing on the subject. This word myself is emphasizing on the subject I. So this reflexive pronoun, when it is emphasizing on the subject I, we call it emphatic pronoun. What we call it? We call it emphatic pronoun. There is one more difference between reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. That is, we can remove the emphatic pronoun from the subject or from the sentence and the meaning is still clear. If we remove the emphatic pronoun from the sentence, the meaning is still clear. But when we remove the reflexive pronoun from the sentence, the meaning becomes, it's not clear. It becomes incomplete. You can see here, I myself got hurt. If I am going to remove this emphatic pronoun, I got hurt. Simply, the meaning is clear. So these emphatic pronouns, these are used just for emphasizing. They have no other use. They are used for showing emphasis on the subject. Without them also, the meaning is clear. The sentence is complete. But in reflexive pronoun, if I'm going to remove this pronoun here from here, the meaning will be incomplete. I hurt myself. I hurt. I hurt whom? The meaning is not clear. So these are having their importance in the sentence. Without them, the sentence is incomplete. But without emphatic pronouns, the sentence is still complete. They are just used to show emphasis. Okay, we can have few more sentences. We can see, you hurt yourself, you yourself got hurt. From the single sentence, we can use all these pronouns in these two sentences to form the reflexive and the emphatic pronouns as well. I hope you are clear with the reflexive pronouns and the emphatic pronouns. Thank you.